Hello, hi my dear friends. Welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss an important topic, that is the digestion of proteins. We know very well in previous classes we have discussed the digestion of carbohydrates. Let us start. Digestion of proteins. So, first of all, what is the source of proteins? Source of proteins. The food that contains the proteins in the form of two types. What is the one is the animal food, second one is the plant food. Animal food and plant food. We know very well animal food that contains the meat like chicken or mutton and also fish. Fish is also protein food. And eggs, cheese, etc. are the sum of animal foods that are rich in proteins. Coming to the plants, peas, nuts, whole grains. So, how these proteins are helpful for the human body. So, see, these are the protein resources. These protein resources are digested in human body through the process called as a human digestive system. And finally, they give the two important things that includes one is the essential amino acids. Second one is the nitrogen resources for the synthesis of non-essential amino acids. So, what it gives? They give directly essential amino acids to the human and also they give nitrogen resource for the synthesis of non-essential amino acids. Then what is the essential and what are the non-essential amino acids? Essential amino acids are the amino acids, they cannot synthesis in our body. Here, non-essential amino acids are the amino acids, they can synthesis. So, what we have to understand is, essential amino acids should be taken through only food resources. But, for the synthesis of non-essential amino acid, our body also required nitrogen resources. That nitrogen resources also given by the proteins which are taking from outside resources. It is clear. So, let us see what are the amino acids which are present in our body and what are the essential and what are the non-essential amino acids. Okay. See, in our body, we have standard 20 amino acids. So, to understand and to remember, I have give some tips for the remembering of 20 amino acids. Let us start. I am going to write complete alphabets of the English. See, let us see A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. We know very well, we have alphabets are 26. But what we have only 20 amino acids. then we have to exclude 6 amino acids from these alphabets. From these alphabets, what are they? 6 amino acids. You can see, here is a 1B. Here is the 1J and Z O U X. To remember these letters, we can write a code, that is Usmania University X person. X person studied botany, zoology, journalism in Usmania University. X person studied botany, zoology, journalism in Usmania
University.
You just remember X. X person studied botany, zoology, journalism in Usmania University. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 amino acids. Nothing but 6 alphabets we have excluded from these 26 alphabets of the English. Let us see what are the these letters, rest of the letters of amino acids. They encode for the amino acids, very important. In examination, they will ask the what are the A which is encode for the which type of amino acid. A encode which amino acid, C encode which amino acid, like this. So be careful to remember. A is the alanine, C is a cysteine, D is a aspartic acid or aspartate also called, E is a glutamic acid, also called glutamate. F is a phenylalanine. G is a glycine. H is histidine. I is a isoleucine, K is a lysine, L is a leucine, M is a methionine, N is a aspergine, P is proline, Q is a glutamine, R is a arginine, S is a serine, T is threonine, V is valine, W is a tryptophan, Y is a tyrosine. See, we have to remember this amino acids and also its respective single alphabet, single alphabet or single codon, single letter codon. Okay, A is alanine, C is a cysteine, D is aspartic acid, G is, E is a glutamic acid, like this. In this, we simply understand A for alanine, C for cysteine, and also G for glycine, H for histidine, I for isoleucine, L for leucine, M for methionine, P for proline, S for serine, T for threonine, V for valine. Okay, the rest of the amino acids, that is aspartic acid encodes for different letter, not a A, that is D. Glutamic acid, it also encodes different letter, not a G, that encodes E. Here also, phenyl alanine, not a P, it encodes by the F. At the same time, lysine, not encoded by the L, it encodes by the K. Here also, aspergine encoded by the N, not a A. And also, glutamine encoded by the Q, not by the G. Arginine encoded by the R, not a A. And also, finally, tryptophan encoded by the W, not a T. Tyrosine encoded by the Y, not a T. So, in this way, we have to understand the what are the different amino acids, they encoding different alphabets instead of the starting letter of the amino acid. Okay, so we have to remember these amino acids very carefully. In examination, they only ask this amino acid, especially these amino acids. They will give A encode by the alanine, C encode by the cysteine, then what is the single letter codon for the aspartic acid? Single letter codon for the aspartic acid or single letter codon for the glutamic acid. They will give G and also E. Many of the people choose the answer is a G, but it is not a G, it is a E. So, in this way, we have to understand this concept. So, let us see what are the essential amino acids. List of essential amino acids. These are also very important. List of essential amino acids. List of essential amino acids. To remember these essential amino acids, there is a code that is Kitchen work from my village gives thrill. Kitchen work from my village gives thrill. See, what are the letters we have to remember? K, W, F, M, V. Thrill. Here is the gives is the only supporting word. Gives is the only supporting word. Kitchen work from my village gives thrill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 amino acids including essential amino acids of standard 20 amino acids. Okay, see. K, W, F, M, V, T, H, R, I, L. We know K is a లైసిన్, K is the lysine, W is the tryptophan, W is the tryptophan, F is the phenylalanine, M is the methionine, M is the methionine, V is a valine, T is a threonine, H is a histidine, R is a arginine, I is a isoleucine, L is a leucine. Elisa leucine. These are the standard essential amino acids from the standard 20 amino acids. This should be remembered. Rest of the 10 amino acids are belongs to the non-essential amino acids. These essential amino acids should be taken through the outside resources, that is in the form of food. Okay, that is in the form of food. Okay, I think it is clear. Let us see how protein is present. So, these are the essential amino acids. And now we are going to see the how protein is made with the amino acids. How protein is made up of with the amino acid. How protein will get digested. See, protein. Protein is a polymer of amino acid. Polymer of amino acid. Polymer of amino acids. Polymer of amino acids, especially standard 20 amino acids. All these monomers of amino acids. Monomers of amino acids forms the polymer through the bonds called as peptide bonds. Peptide bonds. Let us see how peptide bonds is present. For example, I am going to draw the simple amino acid glycine and alanine. See, actually it has a carbon. In one side there is a amine group. In another side, there is a carboxylic group, COOH. One side, there is a R group. It varies from one amino acid to the another amino acid. And one side, another side is a hydrogen. So, I am going to draw the own glycine. That's why it has only H here. Coming to the another amino acid that also contains the carbon, similarly, that also contains the NH2COOH and also H R group is here is a CH3. This is a glycine amino acid, this is a alanine amino acid. Then these two are the monomers. These two monomers together forms the polymers. Especially two amino acids together they form the dipeptide. These forms the dipeptide. If these amino acids are three, then it is called as a tripeptide. It is if they four, they called as a tetrapeptide. See how
peptide bond is formed. Peptide bond is formed by the release of water.
Peptide bond forms by the release of water from these two amino acids.
How it forms? Here the peptide bond is formed. We can remove the water molecules from this formula. How it looks? C double bond O. C double bond O. So, this is called as peptide bond. Here I am releasing OH from this COOH and also one hydrogen from the NH2. So, that gives the one bond that is called as a peptide bond. Okay. In this way,
peptide bonds will forms in between the amino acids. So, let us see. If you draw the two amino acid, that is called as a dipeptide. Simply, this is the example.
If you draw another amino acid, that is a tripeptide. Again, we add another amino acid, that is a tripeptide. So on, it gives the polypeptide.
It gives the polypeptide.
So, these rounds are the amino acids. Amino acids. So, in between these amino acids, there is the bonds. They are called as peptide bonds.
They are called as peptide bonds. Okay. So, how these protein or polypeptide get digested? The food that contains the proteins in the form of the polypeptides. Proteins in the form of the polypeptide. That proteins, polypeptide get converted into the monomers by the action of the human digestive system. To conversion from the polymer to the monomer, we need some enzymes. They called as a peptidases.
Peptidases. These peptidases breaks the bonds which are present in between the amino acids of polymer. These peptidases are two types. These peptidases are two types. One is endopeptidase. Second one is a exopeptidase.
You can see endopeptidases are the enzymes. They digest or break down the bonds in the internal sites of the polypeptides. Like here also, they may here. Whereas the exopeptidases are the enzymes, they break the bonds at the ends of the polypeptide. So, again exopeptidases divided into two types. Amino exopeptidase and carboxy exopeptidase.
We know very well here is the amino group and at the end here is the COOH group.
The enzymes, they break here at the site of amino group, they are called as a amino exopeptidase. The enzymes which breaks at the end of the right side of, this one is the right, this one is the left. Right side of the polypeptide, they are called as a carboxypeptidase because there is a carboxylic acid. Due to the presence of the carboxylic acid end, where the enzymes get digest the peptide bond. That's why they called as the carboxy hexapeptides. Here is the amine group. At the site of near amine group, the enzyme's action will take place. That's why they called as the amino hexapeptidase. In this way, proteins are present in the polymers that are present in the food. That food we are taken by the mouth, and these polymers of our proteins get digested, finally leads to the amino acids. Again, these amino acids formed in the small intestine. That small intestine is absorbed. These amino acid absorbed small intestine get dissolved in the bloodstream. From bloodstream, these amino acids, nothing but essential amino acids plus nitrogen resources. These essential amino acid nitrogen resources dissolved in the bloodstream. This bloodstream gives these resources for the cells of tissue. Tissue can utilize essential amino acid for the synthesis of proteins. And also, tissues can get synthesis the non-essential amino acid by using the nitrogen resources. By utilizing both essential amino acids which are taken by the food and also non-essential amino acid which are synthesized internally, both together again forms the proteins. These proteins have the many functions. Functions in human body. I hope this is very clear. If you really understand this class, please do subscribe my channel and like, share and comment.